Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to create Oracle database on AWS platform. And once you create it, how you can connect that database from your local machine, right? So let's start with the login process. So first of all, everyone, you need to log in with your AWS account, right? And once you log in, on our left-hand side top corner, there is one name, it's called services. You have to click on that and you will have all the list of services. Go to the database section, and a database, as the Oracle is a relational database, you have to click on RDS. Once you click on RDS, you will have this kind of screen, right? So first of all, I already created one database, so you will find 1 out of 40 number. Now click on create database because we need to create new one, right? And here I would like to choose easy to go. That's why easy create. So use recommended best practices configurations, and some configuration options can be changed once you completely create your database or once you launch your database server. So select easy create, select the engine type, it's called Oracle, right? We are just using this specific engine for normal proof of concept and learning. So we don't require the production. So we are going to create dev and test, because here you just compare the resources. Here is a 16 GB of RAM and here is only 8 GB of RAM, right? So database name is, identifier name is my first database, my first DB, master name admin. You have to select password that must be strong and little complex so no one can easily crack your password. Here you can see these are the certain default settings which you can change, right, once you create your database, right? So again, I'm going to show you everything, whatever the things we configure. It's a little small configuration. Now click on create database. Guys, this database will take around 10 to 15 minutes, right? So you have to wait for that, right? Here you can see this is under process, right? And you have to wait for some time. Yes, okay. Meanwhile, let's download the SQL workbench, right? So you can connect your database workbench. SQL workbench. Right, so you have to click on the SQL Workbench download. You will be redirected on this screen and you have to scroll down and you have to click over here. That's a generic package for all the systems, including all optional libraries, right? So just click over here and you have one zip folder. You have to unzip this file. And once you unzip this file, right, you have a list of folders which having the list of options where you have jar file and all that, and in which you will find in this specific file you have a two SQL workbench application, right? That one is having SQL workbench and another one is having SQL workbench 64, right? So those who have a 64-bit architecture, you can click on that. Otherwise, other those who have 32-bit, you have to select normal SQL workbench application type. Okay, so let me check our console is ready or not. So it will take time. This is the folder directory, guys, you can see, right? Okay, and once you click on SQL, right, SQL Workbench, you have, see, as I told you, right, that this is 32-bit and this is 64-bit. So I'm going to click on 32-bit, okay? And here you will have a new profile, right? So guys, new profile, how you have to configure? Here you can see I'm going to configure this, right? And here you have to write my past. For the Oracle database, practical on AWS, right? Okay. Now, guys, what you have to do, you have to select the driver, right? So here you can see you have to select the Oracle JDBC, right? So, and for that, you required one library, right? So here you can see, once you select your profile, you have to go inside this manage driver. And here you can see I have already Oracle database JDBC 8.jar, right? So how you can download this? What you have to do for that? You have to open Google. Right, and you have to write SQL Workbench driver, right? And you have this first option, that JDBC driver SQL Workbench, click on that, right? And just scroll down and you have the popular JDBC driver for all the different databases like Oracle, PostgreSQL, Apache, right? IBM database, MySQL, MariaDB. Okay, here you can see we have the Oracle database, right? So just go inside and click on the URL. It's called ojdbc8.jar. Once you click, you will be redirected on Oracle library page, where you will find all the JDBC driver, including older version of 18C to 19C with having 19.9, but you have to download 19.8 right now. Okay, so just click on that. And one thing you have to remember, guys, before start doing this, you must have to install the Java version 1.8 and above, right? So for that, you have to install it. See, this is for Linux because tar.gz is not for our normal computer. It's for Linux operating system, right? And here you can see these are the different files which are compatible with our like normal Windows operating system. Here you can see this is the Oracle 8.jar. We have to download this. Once you download this, you have to click over here and then just go inside, select Oracle, and here you have to go inside the folder. And you will be find that downloaded JDBC 8 over here. You have to select this, right? I have previously selected the same, so I have two. I'm going to remove this, right? Okay, now here you have one simple URL which you have to change, right? So this is the over here you have the host name, right? So here I'm going to change the host name. Right, host name, you will find this from database console. Go inside the my first db, and once your database will be ready, you will find your endpoint from here, right? But meanwhile, the database is under process. I already have created one, so you will see this is my database endpoint. Right, so what you have to do, you have to just copy, you have to go to the SQL Workbench and add the rate for 2/, then after you have to add your host name, port will remain same. That's Oracle having 1521. And your database name, if you remember, then it's good. If you don't remember, just go inside the configuration and you have will have the DB name, right? And if you want to check our database DB name, go inside, say key, and here you will see this is the database, right? So let's write this name over here. It's a database. Click on OK, right? Here also you have to do the same thing, right? So here I also am going to change the URL host name. This is the my database URL, right? This is my port and this is the name of database. Here you will have the service name. Instead of service name, you have to write the database name. My username is admin. You have to write your password. Password you have to write very carefully, otherwise you guys have a error, right? Okay, now see, once you click OK, they start connecting with your database instance. See, now I am connected. Okay, so let me go inside. Okay, initially you guys have a problem, right? So you are not able to connect, right? Why? Okay, let me check the our database is ready or not. It will take some time. Okay guys, so if you have error, right, what you have to do, you have to go inside the security. You have first of all click on your database, go inside the connectivity and security. There is one option in a left hand side column. It's a security. Where is we're having the database security, VPC security group. Just click on it, right? Once you click on it, this security group have a two types of feature. One is inbound rule and outbound rule, right? So just click on inbound rule, and by default, you all have this option available, all traffic, right? So what you have to do, go inside, edit. Okay, just either you can remove this, right? Or go to the Oracle RDS, select this, your protocol and port by default you will have. And here you have three options, right? So if you can see my IP, then my IP only can allow access this database, right? How you can know the your IP address? So just open Google and what is my IP? Just type this. Right, and you will have your IP address. Okay, say this is my IP address. Right, clear. So you have to use this, but usually we are not going to do that because it's only accessible from that specific network. So we are going to connect anywhere. Right, anywhere it means all the people, all the IP address from all the machines you can access it. Right, so once you save this rule, right, and then you have to again click on connect, you will be redirected with this screen, right? And now this is your screen and you can start creating your normal query execution and all that, right? So whatever simple query you want to execute, like create database or create table name, right? So you can do that. Right, so let's see with a few command. If we have, go inside history. Or if you don't have any history, just open one simple command of create table name. So yes, so here you can see I'm going to create table of one person, copy, right, just paste it, and this is the option where you can execute it, right? Your table person created, right? Now you can insert value in that, right? Do you want to see that? Just go inside and show the DB tree, and you will have your schema where your username is like admin, right? Click on that, click on table, and you can say this is the person table, right? Previously I had created customer table, right, students? So this is the way you can create your complete Oracle database. You can perform all the operation, right? And you can see your schema tree over here, right? Thank you so much, student. If you have any query, please comment your query. I will let you know. Thank you.